Hello friends, I met a friend who had just returned from Dubai. I asked him one simple question, how are you? He replied, in the last 10 years, I never had any health issues. I said, that is really great. He continued, but you know, last week I had a fever for 2 days. I could not bear the body pain. The temperature was too high for me to manage at home. Then I booked a cab and that cab guy came after more than 45 minutes. You know, I was about to be fainted that day. Then I went to the hospital. The doctor said it was nothing serious and he asked me to take any paracetamol tablet for 3 days consecutively. I bought that medicine in that hospital medical shop itself. The next morning, I was all right. No fever, nothing. I got scared. How come such a high fever vanished overnight? Then, you know what happened? By that time, I interrupted and said, I had to go somewhere urgently and I just left that place. After that one incident, I tried to avoid conversing with him because even if I ask a small question, he would explain in details for hours and waste my time. At the same time, if you ask the same question of how are you to someone else, he might just reply fine with no clues to know if he is really fine or not. Like this, we can broadly categorize people into two types. One type will explain even small and trivial things to minute details. The second type would not provide even the minimum details that is required, and you need to keep digging more to get further details from them. One type is interested in watching the news in detail from almost all the channels, whereas the second type is interested to know only the headlines, and that too from even a single channel is sufficient for them. One type of manager will be on your back, monitoring each and every thing that you are doing in detail. There are other bosses who just give you an assignment and would not even ask you anything until the deadline. We call this first category small chunk people because they want to know even the smallest details that is possible. Also, if you ask them for any information, they will provide full details. The second category, being opposite to that of the first, we can call them the big chunk people. They are interested in knowing the overall summary and they will go into the depth only when it is absolutely required. Each category has its own merits and advantages. The big chunk people will be good at fixing the overall goals even for large organizations. When you climb up in your career, the art of taking decisions using the overall summary is very crucial. Seeing the big picture of growth or the consequences of any project is very, very important. The second category of people will be good at breaking the overall goals into many small individual and wherever it's possible, independent modules that can be distributed parallelly to many teams and get the things done. They will be able to point out the detailed steps needed to achieve the overall objectives. So they avoid unnecessary tensions and delays. Now, parents and teachers, I think you understand which category you belong to and to which category each of your teens belong. You need to learn the art of communicating in a way that will build good rapport with each type of teens. If a teen is a small chunk guy, you need to explain in detail. They want everything in detail, sometimes even more than once, whenever you give them instructions. Otherwise, they will not be able to understand what you expect from them. What happens if you explain in 2 lines? They may feel left out or given up without understanding anything from you. The same way, if you keep explaining more than what is needed to a big chunk guy, he will feel bored. Not only that, he may think, am I a fool? Why does he explain so many times in so much details? So you need to provide the overall view in a couple of minutes for them to understand and give more details only if required. What happens if you go on and on and on? He will run away from the conversations, at least mentally. He will try to avoid your phone calls. Most of our videos will concentrate on the art of communicating to different type of personalities, including the teens. So, in this second of a series of videos, we have learned the art of speaking less or more depending on the type of teen you are dealing with. This will really help you understand and handle the teens in a better way. See you in the next video. Until then, bye-bye.